صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين.
إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the purpose of our life. And to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the comprehensive way, according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, it's not limited to one act or the other, or to one part of our body or the other. It's from head to toe. And this is the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And if a person looks into the Quran and into the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, we would see that every part in our body, we use it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill an act of worship. Many different acts of worship. Doesn't have to be something that is used in a ritual form, but we will be questioned about everything we do, anything we say, and the different parts of our bodies, how these parts were fulfilling the purpose of our life, and that is to worship the Creator of the heavens and the earth alone. We're still in the head, and in one particular part of the head, and that is the tongue, this amazing muscle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for us to use it for the sake of Allah, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him with our tongue in matters of dhikr, enjoining good, forbidding evil, reciting Quran, and to stop and to stay away from the things that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we look into the things that we use our tongue to achieve, either we are saying something that is correct and right, or part of the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is to stay away from concealing the truth. Kitmanul haq, concealing the truth, is a major sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemned those who would conceal the truth. Sometimes it is mandatory for the person to speak out and to speak the truth and to explain to the people the truth. Otherwise, they are responsible, they will be questioned, and as a result of that, this can even take them away out of the fold of the truth if they would conceal the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُمُونَ مَا أَنزَلْنَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالْهُدَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا بَيَّنَّاهُ لِلنَّاسِ فِي الْكِتَابِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَلْعَنُهُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَلْعَنُهُمُ اللَّاعِنُونَ. That those who conceal the truth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed and brought down to the messengers, after the matter has been made very clear in the books, these are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse, and also the cursers would curse them too. They are cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and by the creation of Allah. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَبَيَّنُوا فَأُولَٰئِكَ تُوبُوا عَلَيْهِمْ. Except those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives, and those who would rectify and fix their deficiencies, and they would make clear what they concealed. So even the repentance from such a sin is not just to say, oh Allah, forgive me, and that's it. They have to make clear what they have concealed. They have to explain it to the people. They have to show it. They have to be steadfast on the truth. This issue of explaining and talking the truth in some parts of the world and sometimes throughout history caused the people on the truth to even lose their whole entire life. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ, when he said in the authentic hadith, that the best of the jihad, the struggle for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the word of truth in front or within the in front of the of a tyrant or an unjust tyrant. That when a person would say the truth, then this can cause his own life, actually to lose his own life. But this is basically the pledge that a Muslim would take when he says Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah, is to speak the truth when it's needed. Comes with this is to hide and to protect the secret of others. So concealing the truth is a sin, but at the same time, if somebody would tell you a secret, it's amana, it's a trust, that you don't speak out when it comes to the secrets of others and not to expose others. The Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, إِذَا حَدَّثَ الرَّجُلُ بِحَدِيثٍ ثُمَّ الْتَفَتْ فَهِيَ أَمَانَ, which means if a man speak to another man, and he looked on the side or looked behind, he looked like he is saying that in a secretive way, then this is amanah. This is a trust. You cannot break this trust. You have to keep that secret. And you have to keep it, and you have to respect that and never expose the secrets of others. The Prophet ﷺ also, another form of that is when people are together in some form of intimate relationship between husband and a wife. That is to be kept secret between them. That's why it's such an important relationship and an honored relationship that they're supposed to keep whatever is between them intimately together. The Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, إِنَّ مِنْ أَشَرِّ النَّاسِ مَنْزِلَةً عِنْدَ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الرَّجُلُ يُفْضِي إِلَى امْرَأَتِهِ وَتُفْضِي إِلَيْهِ ثُمَّ يَنْشُرُ سِرَّهَا. Something that is very severe and very serious. One of the worst levels among the people in the Day of Judgment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means He is among the people of the hellfire. And not just any level, one of the worst levels. A man that would cohabit with his wife, have relations with his wife, have intimate relations with his wife, and the same thing, the wife towards her husband, and then he would go out and expose their secrets, or she would expose their secrets. The Prophet ﷺ called that a secret, not for the man to go and talk to his friends about what happens intimately between him and his wife. The same thing when it comes to the wife with her friends or whatever there is, this is a secret. To be honored and to be protected, this is part of the religion. And this is something that the tongue either will pass this test or would fail. And this is our life, is to control what we say, to speak the truth and to conceal what we are ordered to conceal. Also in another authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, but this is an incident that happened at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, when Anas radiallahu anhu, and if you remember, we talked about the family of Anas and his mother Umm Sulaym, right? This is a family that needs for us to study what they used to do and what they used to say and their relationship with the Prophet ﷺ. It's a family that loved the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much. They would follow the Prophet ﷺ and do whatever it takes to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anas radiallahu anhu used to serve the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was young. And one time he said, I was late going back to my mother. This is an authentic hadith in Sahih Muslim. He was late going back to his mother because of something, errand that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent Anas radiallahu anhu to do. So he was late going back to his mother. So when he came back, she asked him, where have you been? He said, I was doing something for the Prophet ﷺ, but it's a secret. So listen to what the mother said. When he said that this is a secret, the Prophet ﷺ told me not to tell anyone. So she said to her son, don't you ever speak out or expose the secrets of the Prophet ﷺ. Don't say anything. This is a mother that understood exactly what it means to follow the way of the Prophet ﷺ, ordering her son not to say anything. She did not tell him, but I'm your mother and I want to know exactly what happened, and so on and so forth. It's the Prophet ﷺ. So she told them, never speak out or expose the secret of the Prophet ﷺ. And the same way Anas radiallahu anhu, when he was narrating the hadith, he said to the sub-narrator of the hadith, if I would to say this to anyone, I would have said it to you, O Thabit. So they used to respect that very much. Even on a personal level, sometimes you have to be a little bit secretive about your own personal affairs so that people do not envy you in personal levels. As the Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, he said عليه الصلاة والسلام, استعينوا على إنجاح حوائجكم بالكتمان, which means seek help in fulfilling your duties or doing something that is benefiting to you by concealing it. Your personal affairs, it's nothing to do with matters of the religion. There's no harm whatsoever in concealing this matter, something that on a personal level you're doing. You're initiating a business, for example, and there's no need, there's no benefit of letting everybody know from the first step that you're doing this till the matter becomes finalized and so on. So you use your wisdom and you see what is benefiting, and if there's no benefit of telling others, don't say anything. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned the reason why, and this is an authentic hadith in Sahih al-Jama'. The Prophet ﷺ said, فَإِنَّ كُلَّ ذِي نِعْمَةٍ مَحْسُودٍ, which means every person that has a ni'mah, has a bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, somebody would envy him. So to protect yourself from the envy is try to not to expose your affairs too much to people, especially if there's no benefit behind it. So this is such an attitude that a Muslim would have on the face of earth, that he or she be careful in the things that we say. And this is actually the point of this episode and others, is that we need to watch what we say with our own tongues. So the subject that we're discussing today is, we do not conceal the truth, but at the same time there are secrets, yes. If a person would speak to us, it doesn't have to be that the person would say, listen, this is a secret, do not say anything to anybody. Of course, if a person says that, then it has to be honored, and a person has to keep the secret, unless there is an evil as a result of that. But also, if a person would say something and he looks like he's wanting to keep it as a secret, he's looking on the side, he is lowering his voice when he's speaking to you, that means this is a manner, this is a trust that should not go beyond that same or that particular gathering. All of that is to honor the dignity and the honor of a Muslim. Using the tongue in what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also we abstain and stay away from using the tongue in the things that brings harm or the things that are forbidden, and one of which is to protect the secrets of others, as the Prophet ﷺ taught us in many, many of the ahadith. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us steadfast on the truth and to guide us to use our bodies for the sake of Allah and to be obedient to Allah and to follow the way of the Prophet ﷺ. Wasallallahu sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي
ومحياي ومماتي